Hello everyone, again we are here coming with new topic, that is gear lubrication, which is the part of designing of spur gear. So let's just discuss theory first. Now in case of gear, we know that there should be presence of lubricating oil to control the temperature, as we know that gear having surface to surface contact, and due to that surface to surface contact there is a chances of presence of wear failure, that is scoring and scuffing. And to avoid that, we need to provide the lubricant in between the two contacting surface. For that, we have three important methods for gear lubrication. First is the grease lubrication, second is splash lubrication, or it is oil bath method, and third is the force oil lubrication. Let's start from the grease lubrication. Grease lubrication is suitable for open as well as closed system. But the gear system is or should be run at low speed, then only we can able to use this grease lubrication system. The cooling effect of this grease lubrication is not good when there is a temperature rise under high loading condition and continue operation is there. Again, this grease must be sufficient for good oil or good lubrication purpose, but if that grease is much high in amount, we can say that, then it will be harmful for the enclosed system. So this is the quite disadvantage of this grease lubrication system. Now see, in this video, grease is used between the lubricant between the two mating gears in enclosed gun mechanism. Now next lubricating system, that is splash lubrication or oil bath method. It is again used in enclosed system. For effective application of this splash lubrication, it needs at least 3 meter per second tangential and rotating speed. Again, we should maintain oil level at proper manner. When oil level is high, then there is agitation loss of oil and the lubrication will not effective when the oil level is too low. Then again we have the temperature limitation. The temperature of gear system may rise because of friction losses due to the gear bearings and lubricant agitation. So in this video we can able to see that particular lubrication system. These two mating gears in enclosed box. And we just feel it using of lubricating oil. So lubricating oil level should be sufficient for the proper lubrication. Again, replacement of lubricating oil after some period of time, it is essential. Now at the end, force oil lubrication. Now, force oil lubrication, we have the three methods. First is the drop method. So in this method, an oil pump is used to suck up the lubricant and then directly drop it on the contact portion. Second is spray method. An oil pump is used to spray the lubricant directly on the contact area. And third, oil mist method. So lubricant is mixed with compressed air to form an oil mist and that is sprayed against the contacting region. So here is drop oil method. As you can see, using of pump, oil is dropped in between the contacting surface of gear. Here we have the spray method. So in between contacting surface we spray the lubricating oil. So this is all about the gear lubrication system. Thank you for watching video, and for more conceptual video please do like and subscribe the channel.